I think that especially in the terms of targeting, a lot of the advanced advertising, a lot of these things over time, they've been evolving incredibly quickly. Somewhat in response to innovation, obviously that's been a huge draw, but they've also been evolving over the last several years to reflect the fact that the general data landscape is changing, right? To the point around identifiers, what we can leverage for identity, how we interact with data amidst new regulation and things like that. So, look, I think yes, then we will adapt and we will have to change to sort of meet and excel in the new landscape of how all this the data and identity management works. But that being said, right, just this past week I was out had the opportunity to meet with some international colleagues. There is a path forward, and while things might be different in the future, the speed of innovation gives me hope that not only will we be able to keep up, but we will be able to continue to improve our offerings over time.
What that's interesting. What have you heard from like the parts of the world where they've already gone through heavy regulation, GDPR, and they've made had to make adjustments? Has it upended marketing completely, as some fear?
No, it hasn't. I think that's probably the most the happiest re realization I came to is that sure, do things work a little bit differently? Yes. Is there a lot of adoption in new technologies, clean rooms, things like that? Of course. A lot of the things that we're doing right now here in the US are the same sort of things that I'm seeing play out in other markets to handle these types of regulation. So the good news is I think we're on the right path. We're doing the right times sorts of things. And we look at folks that are kind of further along in that journey than we are. It's a lot of the same approaches, techniques, infrastructures. Sure, does it work a little bit different? Of course. But again, I look at the pace of innovation, the types of data, and how we manage that data and how that's evolving. And we are more than equipped to meet this.
Given this context, it's been a challenge to begin with to measure TV viewers cross-platform. Does it make it that much harder, or are we able to forge ahead?
Well, we're definitely forging ahead. Does it make it more difficult? That's an interesting question because it suggests that it was easy before, right? Or at least simple or some way that to approach it. I actually think that when it's identity management and how we think about identity, especially between digital and terrestrial, is a topic that's really gaining a lot of voice in the room right now, and for good reason. It's something that's inherent across platform measurement. It's a central piece of the puzzle that I think we kind of maybe not has gotten enough time in the daylight as it should have most recently. So yeah, is it going to be complex? Of course, it's already probably even been more complex than I think we've given it credit to. Are there going to be future wrinkles and hurdles that we can't even see coming or predict? Sure. But I mean, I think that's one of the reasons that it's so exciting to work in this industry right now because the pace of innovation is so quick. So yeah, is it going to be hard? Of course, it's always been hard. But as an industry, we're taking that challenge head on, and I feel like we're going to end up in a great spot.
Where are the pain points right now, or like in the next few months, in terms of managing identity across platforms and trying to reconcile all the different data that you have coming your way?
So I think there's a lot of research and work being done right now. The SIEM has done some studies around this. There's a lot of other companies popping up, TruthSet, things like that, that are really focused in on this issue. I think that a lot of the work and kind of where it's going to be focused is really making sure that we're taking advantage of the best data possible when we think about how we're doing identity management, and also that we're doing so in a way that is more protected and privacy oriented than it ever has been before. How has this kind of played itself out in the industry? We're all talking a lot about identity right now, and for good reason. We're all talking a lot about data collaboration platforms and no-send data environments for good reason. So we're already kind of seeing that evolution happening. And I think over the next 6, 12, 18 months, these conversations are become increasingly interesting.
Lastly, Travis, in the broader digital landscape, these changes seem to have given more advantage to the big guys. The giant tech platforms seem to be winning. Are we going to see a similar dynamic at play in television, or is it just inherently different?
I do think it's inherently different. One of the things that I think is very powerful in television right now, especially as we talk about a lot of the evolution and the companies that we've been working with in the space, the big identity providers, is there's a lot of transparency into what we can do, what we cannot do. And there's a lot of transparency into how it all works kind of behind the scenes. And when I see the transparency that TV is bringing in these types of things, that's something that the big digital players don't offer. And I think that's a really big advantage of television, the fact that it's open and it's you can interrogate it and you can poke around and we're here to show you how it works. And I think that as a result, as we continue to evolve down the path, and as advertisers and agencies are continue to ask us questions like, well, exactly how are you handling these problems? The ability to answer those in a clear and open way is going to be a huge advantage for television.